Hi, good evening. Welcome to Upfield 1969. And tonight's sharing session is about food photography for anyone. And in fact, before we move forward, do start like and share. Share your friend, especially because the fact that it's supposed to start at 9 o'clock, but good thing is actually our time is already all prepared. So it's like 8:30. So those friends that you shared earlier, keep them on board by tagging them. And I believe a lot of friends out there that love to eat like me, love to cook like him, at the same time also wanted to improve our photography at the same time to make it nicer and make it nicer and prettier. Correct,
correct. It's all about the photograph these days. The eyes eat first.
Yes, I eat first. So let's share. I'll do my sharing now. Okay, I'll text some friends, invite them over. Yeah.
How many friends you got?
A lot, man.
Half the people on my Facebook I don't know.
So youngster actually use IG more than Facebook.
No, I'm not young.
Compared to being younger than me, but
okay, younger than you.
Yeah, the interesting. Still old, yeah. Still. But you can see from the fact that who is chef, who is the eater. Yes, okay, continue sharing. Okay, tell your friend, like the page, ask your 1969, share.
Like and share. Okay.
And always share in my session. I always feel that in our session, when you share itself, right, usually you tag yourself, you can replay. We can replay itself, right? A lot of time, whether tips that you learn, whether things inside that you take away, you can recap again. So do share, okay? So I think most of people are already online. Yep. Yes, I can see Alice Teo online, and the rest of people. So okay, good. Yep. So let's together welcome everybody to Upfield 1969. And tonight's sharing session is food photography for everyone.
Yay!
And yeah, and tonight is still the Chinese New Year, the 12 days of Chinese New Year.
Ah, yes.
So as Chinese or even any region, food is actually is a basic of celebration, correct?
It's it goes across all cultures, lah.
Yes.
It doesn't matter which country you're from, still have to eat, lah.
Yes. You're already so excited to share. So before, let me introduce. It's my special guest. He's actually Baba Bjorn. So initially, when I see his name Bjorn, how to pronounce? Then realize, oh, it's called Bjorn.
Yeah, I get a lot of people calling me Bjorn, John. Like, you know, sometimes they leave out the B, sometimes they leave out the J. So it's like, but it's pronounced Bjorn. So yes, thank you very much, Edmund, for having me tonight. Yes.
So he's actually a chef and a photographer. So to me, I always feel that a lot of situation where you thought you are only one skill, but if you know that you got chance to do something more, that's where you learn. So I look at Bjorn itself. There's so many things that is like, so many things to talk about him. So let him share about himself a bit, introduce yourself.
Okay, thank you, Edmund, again for having me this evening and also for Upfield for inviting me over just to share tonight. Again, my name is Bjorn. I've always been a chef. I've loved food. But also, just a bit more about me. Currently, I am working at this place called Tingkat Pernarakan. I am the outlet manager at the Tampines Smart Outlet. So shout out to my crew who's watching now. Or if you all haven't closed yet, please make sure you all close properly. I need my store back tomorrow. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, and other than that, as you can see from the overlays here on my photos, yeah, I've always loved food. Growing up in a Pranakan household, you know, food has always been something that is very close to the heart. Doesn't matter what kind of day you've had, you know for a fact that when you go home, your mom is there to give you that good meal that you can at least looking forward to like, when you go home. Mm-hmm. And of course, as a photographer, I think, yes, I like to, as I think you can see from Edmund's, you know, title, Moments of Edmund, I think that's actually a very good, you know, consolation of what you know you will say as capturing that moment. You know, Emma, you shared me once, right? Having that moment. Yes. So yes, I think that for me it's just that as well, like capturing that moments and this kind of thing you don't plan one. You know, yes. You just happen to see, right? You just pile on.
Yes,
and the best thing is like you picture me. The camera you have with you is on your phone nowadays.
Yes.
That's the thing also. So yes, very interested, very excited to share with you about just some tips and tricks on what we do from not just the kitchen, but also right to the end product as well.
So in fact, we're very thankful that this Bjorn, which we mentioned, is supposed to be operating in the restaurant. I got to tell the staff close properly. And he's here. So she give us 45 minutes of our time.
Thank you, boss.
Yeah, I must really thank his boss as well. And the kidding, actually, in fact, it's about Pranakan food.
Yes.
And to know him as a Pranakan, authentic Pranakan guy, yet important thing, learn, know how to cook. And at the same time, know how to take pictures again. It's like so wonderful. So just a quick introduction from just how I share. In fact, the takeaway to me is actually, if a chef can cook, yet can also take nice picture, same as people like us, the audience out there, if you love to eat, if you can master how to take nice picture itself, right, you'll be complete the whole journey of really appreciate the food, appreciate the people behind the cooking of the food itself. Yeah, so
it's also like how you say, like now, you know, during the whole COVID situation, everybody has become home cooks.
Yeah,
starting your home business and everything. Yeah. So if you do have the whole talent of doing both the cooking and also taking the photographs, you power out basically yourself. You know how to make, you know how to market. You don't have to spend extra money in terms of capital because it's a home business and it is. And it's all my Instagram, like everybody scroll through, like, you know. So that's also a very good skill to have.
I think he brought a very good point, this beyond, because every day a lot of people learn the skill, whether it is for your own entertainment or leisure, some people use it for a business. Mm. And a business of photography itself, it's not just about taking pictures, it's actually the complete, we can say it's a marketing communication, right?
Yeah,
that's what you did for the restaurant itself.
Correct. So actually, I mean, for me myself as well, I mean, given the opportunity at Pernarakan, I don't just, you know, run the shop. I actually do the whole from start to end. So I cook, I play, I shoot, I do the marketing material, and then I eat. Yeah, because the food cannot waste, so I eat lor.
So what we're talking, not just about talking show. Later, there'll be tips of how to take pictures. Based on the chef perspective. Mm. But a lot of time as a diner itself, you actually, like what we discussed, a lot of time we actually, the phone is actually the master of any food that come into the table first. Mm. So before I get it, our camera eat first with the phone.
Now last time they say that eyes eat first, right? Now it's camera eat first.
So that's like today take away actually, in fact, it would be very good to hear about the chef perspective, how you actually look at the food, how you actually prepare the food in the food photography method, the angle, and a perspective. So the three tips that I'm also looking forward to learn from him.
Yeah, we all learn from each other.
That's
the most important.
Okay. So it'll be good to actually hear from you. What are the basic ingredients of a good food photography?
Okay, I think that we can break it down into three different topics or, you know, areas of discussion. First one, of course, will be plating. Okay. Then after that, we go into something a bit more technical, which could be lighting. And then the lastly, of course, is composition. How do you actually compose the photo so that it will not only help you market, like, you know, the aftermath of it all, but also know for a fact that you don't have to reshoot because you never think of the composure. Composition also is very important because you don't just shoot, what happened this, after that, sekali you go and give your designer or whoever, right? Then you realize, this one don't have, that one cannot fit the text and everything. Yeah. Then also you have to go and reshoot, waste time again. So that one we'll touch a bit more on that also at the end. So it gives you a more holistic experience.
So in fact, the audience out there, if you all got any question or anything they want to ask at the same time, do feedback. I can see a lot coming in already. So continue to like and share. And I believe a lot of our friends will benefit at the same time. So in fact, good to share. So your first tips, I think everybody also looking forward to what is something that they can start. So you say plating, I just put one word. A lot of time, because I'm the eater, I got no chance to plate. But a lot of time, it's a restaurant kitchen, they plate. All you right. Can see, I just turn around. Plating.
For this plating wise, right, for me as also a chef, I mean, given my mentors that I've had in the kitchens that I have worked in, they always say that, you know, we have to make sure that the plate go out must be at least sui lah. The side not dirty, the everything is there. So because why, generally most of the time as a general consumer, you would not, you know, go and touch the thing, adjust, and then make sure it's like, you just see what is there, just take. And so that's actually also a very important thing for people because, you know, especially for us, when you put on the table, make sure it's presentable because people, as you're saying, they'll just take and then you'll put on social media. After that, let's say, then there's proof, you know, of what your restaurant, the standard is like.
So that's
also how you sell your product also. So it doesn't mean just because the food is ugly. I mean, you can just touch up a bit if you want. I can show you how little also, if you want.
Okay, good to show. Maybe the first step of your
plating, right?
Yeah, plating. How do we do it?
Okay, I've got a couple of plates here. I mean, just to give a general, showcase of what we can you can use. And these are, of course, brought by the outlet, basically, you know. So wait, let me see. I put here a bit more first, so you can see.
Yeah, I can see.
Okay. So
you can look at the camera also. We explain.
Okay, very good. Okay, so you see, we have some, like say, different kinds of plates. You have your standard, you know, white bowls here that you have. These can be used for monotonous colors, like say, if you have something like in the Pranakan cuisine, right? Like say, ayam bokrok. For those viewers who know what it is. and also maybe like what I'm going to bring up, which is babi bong teh. It's a very monotonous kind of color. So in order to bring that dish out, you don't want to have something that is too, you know, fanciful like this.
It's a very good point, because a lot of times I look at my mom's kitchen or which I look at whatever plate I have, something can be very cluttered. But continue. Oh, very interesting.
So yeah, anyway, because if you have, when you have this kind of plates, actually you can pair it, like say with the food that you have, but you have to be very careful. So of course, even be it maybe because if it's a main dish, it could it be an appetizer or is it a dessert? Or it could be even to the theme of the whole night itself. So just to share a bit more, I mean, if let's say y'all didn't already catch on, besides the Pernarakan doing thing, what do you call it, the normal fare of food, we actually do omakase.
Omakase.
So omakase is more like what a chef will bring out, and then we have the 8 course at Owen Road outlet.
Okay.
So those who are interested, you can give them a call. So what actually, if you do that omakase, right? So it's actually very those, you know, they always see people eat so small, right? So something like that, no? You can use this kind of thing.
I see.
But so it's again on your dinner setting at night. If like say you're at home, like say if you're communal, use a bit more of something like this, lah. But of course, if you're going for omakase, something small like this also will be presentable, then you take also swim. Okay, so I will show you lah in the end. So that will be on plating. So later after this, then I will bring out the lighting part. Sure. So I will
you may want to put the food first to the lighting. A lot of people also see how the food presented in the Pernarakan.
Okay, so what we have here today is what we call babi bong teh. So babi bong teh is shot using basically. I mean, it's cooked using sam jambak, which is the pork belly. Pork belly, and stewed in a mushroom, and also we call it tau chiong base. Okay, so it's a tau chiong base. So you can have your things over here, like that. So always give height lah for plating. I always like to know that you should, don't spread it out.
I see.
Got more things.
So actually layer instead of flatten it.
You just slowly put on top. Okay. So
the sauce, you can actually, when you want to shoot, then you put more again.
You see like those commercial, right? Sometimes you okay one. Actually the end, the behind, they throw the thing out, actually shoot at the moment.
But most of the time when we are in the restaurant or at the home itself, you can't get too much.
Cannot. We measure, make sure
it's
our best of our ability.
So color. So we always say, 色香味俱全. So color, but your chopstick, this one.
Tweezer.
Yeah.
Okay. So
the audience out there, you want to really seriously do plating, invest in the tweezer.
Yes. This is actually very important because it helps you navigate the smaller areas of the dish, lah. Okay.
Yeah.
So actually, this is what we have done. Okay, at the side. Now, so something like this, as you can see, with the camera, you can open put it here. So you see on this one already, it looks pleasing.
It looks
appealing already.
You can see the dimension.
Correct. The dimensions of the dish is not so just. No, scoop and put
on top. So the plating is because it's not the round flat one. The curve itself is already
the shape of the bowl gives you the texture.
Give people the texture and make people wanting to actually look what's inside.
It draws them in.
Yeah.
It draws them into the whole
thing. The camera, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we see from that?
You can bring closer.
To here?
I'll
bring here.
Okay.
You smell. The whole place smell very nice, actually. Not because of the tau chiong, lah. You know, everybody. That's the thing you can always tell. Okay. With this is done, right? The next thing, of course, we have to look at is telling you lighting.
Lighting, yeah.
Photography is all about lighting. It's not about the camera that you use, to be honest.
Yes. In fact, a lot of people out there always ask, what camera phone you use, which brand of camera you take,
or which is the best camera.
Which is the best camera. Yeah.
Honestly, any camera also can.
Interestingly, Baba Bjorn, in fact, you're also similar to me that we also use DSLR. But because a lot of time where it's at the moment, camera phone is still the best in a way.
Yes.
A lot of nice pictures that you see from your Instagram is actually shoot using your phone, right?
All the photos you saw just now on the overlay actually is shot on my phone itself.
Yes.
You know, from, I don't know if you all saw just now, you were asking me just now, is that the normal instant me? The Indomie? That one is actually Indomie only. Then you play it nicely, right? Then after that, you look at it.
And use your phone to take also.
Use my phone to take.
That's why the audience out there, in fact, to actually take a very nice picture, it's not about the camera, it's about how you actually position it.
Your framing,
your plating,
yes.
And the next one is like
it's
really lighting. So lighting is really very important.
Yes.
Yeah.
So for lighting, right? Actually, this one, for me, the best light is the skylight.
Ambient light.
No, sunlight.
Oh, sunlight. But sunlight cannot change in different timing.
Correct. So that's why they call golden hour.
Golden hour.
Sometimes so you get the golden, nice golden hour. Yeah. So for me, I a bit like say if you want to have lighting, I don't really do more on like say studio lighting or like this. I like to have maybe one source and then one additional just to cast out shadow. So maybe next to a window, sometimes you have a nice natural light, right? Also, it's actually the best light that you can have. But of course, not to say you don't have to buy all the expensive equipment. Your phone also, you can. You just use. They have this app.
Interesting.
Let me show you. It's on an Android. So you have this app where you can actually turn your phone, you see, into a mini box LED light. So you can just do like a filler when you want to take the photos on the side.
Yeah, I think this one must add actually. During my earlier session, in fact, I bought a small ring light and I got to bring it around itself. And now I realize that there's apps. What's the name of this app again?
It's called Screen Flash. I think it's only available for Android. I don't know iOS. Must go and check.
Okay, must go and check.
Later we fill up the contents and then let them know where you can find all this stuff. So yes, on this app also, it's not just the white color. They have you can actually toggle different colors. So like say if you want orange color, warm light also.
Warm light. Wow.
Also you can do all this.
Wow.
So this one is by the way it's free. It's
warm light. Let me see the warm light.
Warm light, is it? So you can.
Hey, warm light. Where is the warm light?
You can change the color.
Wow.
Like on this one, you can like say change maybe yellow light if you want. So there, it goes like the yellow. I mean, it's a bit hard to see for the camera lah. But yes, this is a yellow light for over here. Can the camera?
So interesting. Yes. So interesting.
So actually, your phone is actually a very versatile tool. Okay, for myself, of course, not sponsored, by the way, I use a Huawei Mate 20 Pro. Okay, it's still to me one of the most versatile cameras out there. A lot of people say, hey, your phone dropped until tomorrow, 1 million pieces, how come you don't want to change?
Yeah, okay, so
I know you see all the crap, everything.
Yeah.
But you know what? It shows that to the commitment of a product that actually, you know what, doesn't matter whether you drop your phone a million times or your camera a million times. If you know
the mechanism inside is still the quality is still good.
Correct. Yes, so so that'll be on lighting. But of course, if you do have the budget to go like say bigger and you want to buy bigger lights, of course you can go and try those.
In fact, a lot of commercial photography itself, the acceptance from the advertiser, from the customer, the client itself, a lot of times they still want big camera. Previously it was about medium format. But now, of course, they progress. The digital camera is palatable, and now actually they also want DSLR that also can shoot into a video.
Correct. Actually, those cameras not say they're not good. It's just that, like, say if you want to shoot bigger projects like a billboard or editorials, yes, you need those kind of high resolution camera. But everything from Instagram nowadays, they have already revolutionized down to like your phone quality is more than enough to shoot a pretty picture.
I agree. In fact, the one that launched, same thing again, I'm not endorsing Samsung, but Samsung S21, they can actually screen freeze a video. So you always believe that people always shooting sports, the big lenses. But imagine the video that you're watching a soccer match, they can zoom into the particular goal or the goalkeeper itself, right, on the video.
And they freeze it.
And they actually become a photo, and they become a telephone, they become a newspaper, print itself. So I can see that with the technology,
the resolution can
be good enough that actually in fact no need to actually have a super big camera. It can freeze it's consider video 8K. So instead of 4K, 8K.
Shoot 8K.
I think the lighting is very important.
Yes.
Yeah.
So okay, lastly is actually what I was talking about earlier, which is the composition of it.
Yes.
So when we talk about composition, okay, before we get there, sorry, I would like to plate the last one also.
Still got one more dish.
I still got one special dish.
Okay.
This one over here is what we call pulut sakaya.
Hey, so sharp and so straight.
Okay.
Is it machine cut or is it machine made?
This one I give you a tip, okay? If you can see over here, so I'll give you a tip, okay? To get a nice straight line, right? Very simple.
How?
Use dental floss.
Dental floss.
The no taste one, just put dental floss, you cut through. That one will give you a very nice straight line.
Wow.
Like, you know, last time, your mother used to cut the egg, right? They say you know, the egg. Same concept, this one.
Okay? I see.
So this one now I'll show you. I was trying to explain to you, right, that sometimes your plates can also make a difference. Now, if you see, if I put the pulut sakaya on this, you look at it immediately, because the pulut sakaya is so monotonous in terms of it has a structure of the greens, then you have the whites, the plate actually complements.
Yes, if you put the white color plate, then it'll be too blends in really.
Yes, because of the white color pulut. So this kind of plate actually does, you know, complement it a bit.
So it's got to be shallow lah. If it's too deep,
of
you already cover this
yes,
whole...
Yes, yes, yes. That I agree also. Actually, if it's shallow, so you can actually bring out the dish.
I see.
This one has no choice lah, because it's got kuah. Got the sauce inside. So yep. You put too shallow, I think all spill out also. Okay. So for the last one, after that, we're talking about was composition, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. This one, how do I say? This one, I think we can focus, target more on the home business owner for marketing purposes.
Home business owner, actually. Audience out there, if you're a home business owner, or even you're not yet, you love to cook. Who knows, actually, your talent actually being so-called recognized by the fact that you got start taking nice picture.
Yes.
People start
yes,
inquiry. Yes. Same as 12 years ago when I started taking photography as a passion.
Yes.
Then after 1-2 years of taking, people start approaching me, start asking, hey, how much you shoot per project? Or can you help me to shoot for my wedding? Then, can start charging. That was 11 years ago. So same thing again, it's like you never know that because you learn some skill. At the same time, this skill actually will bring you some
another source of
opportunity.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so the last thing for the composition. Okay, let's say for this one, if your instance you're in the shop, some don't say home first, of course, where you want to take, you have to determine which one is your focus.
It's good that our ring light already got some light source, really.
In a way, so of course, I think Edmund will understand with this. Like, say, if it's just your phone, right? Edmund, do you remember the time we were discussing about the three different kind of angles that people like to take?
Yes.
So it was the 90. Sorry, this is the zero lah. We say zero lah, okay?
Okay.
So zero, and then we have the 45 or 35, and then we go the top shot, which is the 90.
Okay, very good. Can you share with the audience every angle, what is the key different thing that is you want to show? Because I always believe that, let's say it's a hamburger, you got to show layer, then front view will be perfect.
Correct.
But you show the top view of burger, just a burger. You know,
you see only the sesame
only the sesame pie.
But actually, you can also do top view for a burger.
Oh, you stand a bit more.
So you show the different layers.
Okay.
So this one's all up to to individual preference lah.
Okay,
whether you want to show.
Okay. So for this case, let's say we were to shoot this
90. Yeah.
0 degree. Right?
0, 0, 0.
What's the key thing that because you want to shoot 0 degree?
So if you shoot at zero, right, what you will get actually is more of a how we get a camera to show what I showed?
Then we got to use the you got to come over the other camera. So which angle you want to shoot?
We shoot zero first, look, then you can see from here. Okay, this one is
very nice.
See, you shoot zero,
okay, audience out there. Later, the picture that he shoot, right? We'll post back in Axio 1969 for you to take a look of the final product.
Yeah.
Or the final shoot. Okay. So in fact, Baba Bjorn will also edit at the same time. So you actually will see the pictures, how it's being taken now, eventually the final product.
Okay.
Very interesting.
So let's say you have this over here, like as y'all can see from my screen.
Wow.
Okay. It's always good to have something at the background.
So interesting.
There, but not there. So it fills up the screen. But of course, a composition does come with the whole idea of your final product that I was telling you about. Whether is it in the end, is it going to be a poster? Because if it's a poster, do you know where your content is going to be laid out?
I think it's a very, very good point when you mentioned, is it what layout? Is it a IG square layout?
Correct.
Is it a landscape or is it a poster?
Yeah.
Or is it a
Facebook post?
Yeah, I think
you
good to actually have this thing in mind before that.
Yes. So you see, you can also shoot, if you can see from my camera here, on this way.
Behind camera, make sure you can see.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's say we shoot this way. See, so let's say if you do it as a shot like this, you have all the headspace at the top. That's for you to, like, say, do all your editorials, maybe a small write up on what this dish is and everything. Yeah. So that's the idea, lah. Make sure you know whether your final product, Facebook, like you said, Instagram, Square, you know, what's your ratio? All this also you can start reading up. Like, if you're,
okay, so audience out there, I think we got a lot of things to interestingly learn and to take away, because a lot of time when we look at a food itself, we straight away zoom in to just look at it. But end of the day, you look at the composition by the 0 degrees. Actually, I seldom use 0 degrees angle because I always feel that I want to shoot more of the food.
A lot of people like to use the standard one. It's like that one. Then the hand and the finger also must go out. I don't know how come the finger must go out.
Maybe
stability. But I always like to hold this way. So basically, this one also, it's a good way to hold. It's because then you get I don't know why I say the stabilization.
Stability, yeah.
Yes. And then your elbow, huh, if you can, right, put on the table.
Wow.
So you put like that, right? Basically, you almost one hand or so you can focus. You tap like that. So this will become your tripod.
Yeah.
You hold it like that. So this is so around, let's say, a 35 degree angle is what I'm doing over here right now. So you just agar from that. Okay. So you can get a good perspective of the back, but you still see your focus of the product. Okay. So then the last one, of course, is what we like a lot of modern people like to do, what we call flat lay. Just now, I think if you saw some of my photographs, I got there was a flat lay I did. That one, I stand on the chair and stand on the table. The chair was on the table.
This chair, I think.
Not this chair. The chair, very good one.
Okay,
on the table, and I stand on the chair on the table because too many products, so much, so very high.
I see.
But short on this phone also.
I see.
Also, okay. So, like say, for instance, now, I can stand, the attention is going to go a bit. So, if you see, you can put up like that.
Audience can see also. Yeah.
Okay. But you see, like that, very boring, right? You can see from my angle, right? Very boring. So what I have is here this. So when you do type of this is just a bit of an extra for y'all,
Wow.
Like say if you do flat lay.
Yes.
You must always have props on.
Yes, I think the last session we talked about food photography, props actually play a part to enhance the composition.
Yes.
To enhance a story.
Yes.
So whether it's a home cook. You actually got your mom's roller. Let's say you do a bread, the roller, you sprinkle some flour itself. It's actually home cooked. And so, actually, wow.
So first thing, like what we like to do is what we call add texture to whatever composition that you have.
This one I thought you'll be wearing.
Cannot fit.
You know what I mean?
It's a bit too small. Okay. Some become big. If I wear, it become big. Okay. So this one is this. So let's say if I do from this, maybe I take this.
Wow.
Natural, just if you don't know what to do, just throw on the table and see where you roll. Honestly, that's what I always like to
do. You need to flatten this thing to actually, or
no,
you actually get
you don't
the...
have to. You what you want from flat lay, right? Is more of what you have, like the natural texture of your what you're creating is creating.
So this kind of idea is actually may not be just food, it can be any product, it can be it can be a cosmetic.
Cosmetic.
It can be a watch. It can be anything that you actually
it's
use.
It's just basically how you perceive from the, like a bird's eye from the top view.
I see.
So if you see from here now, from my camera, if you can
see. Wait for the camera to take a look. Yeah.
Can the camera see what I'm doing? Okay. So if you look right now, like how I'm taking it, it actually dramatically changes the way the photo is looking, even if you can see. As compared to just now.
So the audience out there, actually, in fact, same thing again. Share and like the page. Eventually, you can go back and review. The interesting part is later, Baba Bjorn will actually, in fact, post the picture back into our Art Field 196 to look at the final product. So while we're looking at the process, how we do it, actually the step one, plating, second one actually is about lighting, now it's composition.
Yeah.
Later, when you actually revisit our page again, Art Field 196 again, you actually will see the actual pictures. So in fact, I find it very interesting because this is the first time that actually, in fact, food photography, I have another person that actually we sit down together and we talk and we connect. The interesting point is actually everybody got different kind of ideas and getting things done. The same perspective, I may look at this angle, he may look at this angle. I may say mine is actually nicer, he is nicer. It's actually back to individual perspective and how you actually appreciate food.
Food, art, design, all subjective.
Yes.
Same, very much so. Especially for food. To you, maybe salty. To me, maybe sweet.
Yep.
Who is right, who is wrong?
Yep.
At the end of the day, Hokkien people go on saying, Huanghi Teo Ho.
Huanghi Teo Ho.
Happy can already. In life must be happy.
Yes,
that's
the
most important.
Yes.
You are happy, you cook, show happy. Well, people can taste the happiness.
Yes, I think
that's what you say. But you say you cannot bake when you are angry.
Angry.
Or you cannot cook when you're angry.
Wei Pong, Wei Pong.
No, just Wei Pong. Wei Ngam.
Wei Ngam.
Wei Ngam, I tell you first. So that's why sometimes you go to your favorite Char Kway Teow store, that day they say, hey, today like not nice. Maybe because the uncle angry or the auntie also angry. Next day you go back there, hey, how come so nice today? But same auntie cook. Maybe she huanghi lah, she touch 40.
Okay.
Who know, right? That kind of thing. Yeah.
So, yes. Interesting. Interesting. So to me actually, in fact, it's something that always learning. I always say that every day is learning new things. So in fact, from the experience that I see again, these three ingredients is very important. So whether is it for food you are eating or you're cooking. So if you are the one that cook itself, right, imagine you can showcase to more people how you're actually able to take the nice picture. And the key thing, you put so much effort in the cooking, but if you actually take a very sweeping the photo, you actually make a wasted effort that you actually showcase yourself.
Actually, that is very true, because if you think about it nowadays also, Evan, you know, who, okay, like say last time, maybe our father and our grandfather time, okay, you want to see the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah.
You have to go to Paris, right?
Yeah,
must buy a plane ticket, travel there, right?
Yeah.
Nowadays, people just Google Eiffel Tower can see. But how often would you actually know the famous cafes or the independent cafes around in Paris? It's actually by Instagram.
Yeah, it's
so true. People actually nowadays go on food tours saying because of Instagram, hey, this cafe in Paris, the baguette sibe hotel. So they actually go there and see that. Yes, you go to Paris to see the, you know, the Eiffel Tower and such.
Attraction, yeah.
But it's also in the end, the food. That
so it's a localized environment that you're able to capture.
Correct. So that's why you see, you know, places like TripAdvisor and all this, right? They actually ask people to submit their photos and stuff because that's what actually attracts people. I go there, yes, I go there to see the Eiffel Tower, but I also want to eat that famous gelato ice cream from you know, this particular street. So this all this will help because then it will help also businesses to promote you know, their business also.
Yes. In fact, it's a very good point because during COVID itself or during CB itself, a lot of times it's the photograph that actually attract people to actually go and try the food.
Yes.
So the time actually we always say support the hawker, support the local. Correct. That's where food photography able to actually so-called enhance the store, the cook, the chef, the food itself to bring it to the audience that actually you should try the food.
Correct. I agree.
Yeah. So any other last tips before we actually say bye-bye to everybody and everybody should start trying the shooting and may go to a restaurant and try the food.
Yeah, do drop by. I'm there Monday to Sunday. So if you see me, there's no issue. But last tips on a serious note. Actually, honestly, don't think too much. Feeling. Like say when you cook fried rice also, I've got feeling one. Cannot say 100 gram of this, 100, no such thing one.
Yeah, we got one.
You sprinkle here, sprinkle there.
Wong Si Lai, our session one, Wong Si Lai, she also said, agak-agak lah.
And that is true. Sorry to say, but Asian cooking easy is cooking. All about the heart and the tongue lah.
Yeah.
Too sweet, put salt. Too salt, put sweet. Easy lah, that one lor. In the end, that's how you cook from the heart. That's why I say cook from the heart lor.
Yes.
So photography also say, don't think too much. You think sweet, just take. It's always again like what we discussed, your own perspective, your own story.
Very good. Very good. In fact, we always say, those who are actually prepared, you are ready for better things. So in fact, if you actually equip yourself with the three pointers that Baba BJ mentioned, it's about plating. So next thing, when the food come in, whether the parsley, is it flattened? Can you actually adjust a bit about the parsley to stand out? Or the key thing actually, the next thing is about the lighting. So lighting actually, in fact, thanks to his sharing, what's the app again?
Screen Flash, I think.
Screen Flash. If you can Google Screen Flash App Store, that would be very good. Because if you want orange light, just turn to orange light. You want daylight, you want any light to actually display. Then the key thing, composition. So I also enjoy the fact that composition, even this apron, which we always kind of use only when you use it, you need it when you use it. But you use the background itself, right? It's actually very interesting. The texture, the lines, it's a good composition.
So, and you don't have to spend too much, honestly. Yeah. Like you realize, like say this apron, honestly, I didn't bring one. The only hang behind one. So I happen to see and I think about, hey, actually can share about this kind of thing. So you can use whatever you have in the house.
Yeah.
Inspiration is at your fingertips, like Google, Pinterest. Use it as an inspiration. Don't need to copy. Just inspire. See how you can make it your own. This is what I also like to share.
Very good.
Thank you.
Baba, Bjorn, and thank really, it's very inspiring. And the key thing actually, this takeaway, three simple tips, is a very good takeaway. And the key thing, I believe that for good photography is for anyone.
Yes.
Seriously, whether you're a chef, you're a homemaker, you're anybody out there, you learn the three tips, you can shoot any nice picture. Yes. And the key thing, I always believe that we must appreciate the person that cooked. So appreciate the chef. Always in the kitchen, you see the food coming. Some people complain, why it takes so long? I can't wait.
My chef very busy.
So we must appreciate the people behind the kitchen and we appreciate the food so that we can take a very nice picture and enjoy the journey and be a foodie.
Yes, and okay? Also help the business also.
Help the business, help the local, especially during this period.
You what, I what, everybody what together.
Okay, so thank you so much.
Thank you again.
Baba Bjorn.
Yes.
So looking forward to taste your food.
Ah.
And all the audience are actually waiting for your picture to be final product.
Okay.
Sure to ask Bjorn 1969 and they'll visit the picture later.
Okay.
Thank you everyone.
Thank you.
Okay, see you on the next session.
Bye.
Yay.